What a great game that was. What a great set to start off this stream, guys. Is everyone hyped? If everyone was really hyped for that set, everyone give some Pwez in the chat. Let's get some Pwez going, guys.
All right.
Zool, I won the bet, but I wish I didn't. I feel so guilty.
Worst. Okay. Immediate strip of cheerleader status. Shaking my head.
Oh, Zool.
Goodness. Who should we tune into next?
So, with matching a breakthrough, going three, losing 3-2, that almost wraps up the entire first round. We only have Unknown and Leviathan left, and Kairos and Donkey Nuts. Donkey Nuts being a pickup team by the legendary Pleb himself.
Pleb never got disciplined as a child. He doesn't know how to function as a normal human being in society. So he does things like names his pickup teams Donkey Nuts.
And shout outs to his parents for that, because it's great.
Ooh, let's turn into Tomo. Toon Belove? Belove? I don't know what that word is.
What's the username?
Toon Bellevue? You mean we're going to watch them play against Leviathan?
Toon Bellevue?
Yes.
I don't think it's Bellevue.
Let's see. Because they are mid-match right now, right?
Well, I mean, if they're mid-match against... No, Tomo's already over. Tomo went 3-0 against EDPP. They're just waiting for their next match.
Okay, so they're waiting on Leviathan. Gotcha.
Yes, they're waiting on Leviathan.
Gotcha. And we got another donation. Zool99, trying to pay for my sins.
You're the man.
Shipping in $10. Thanks.
Zool, how much have you donated now, dude? Jesus.
Zool is a legend. Zool is a hardcore follower of my stream, and he's one of my favorite viewers. I love when he comes into my stream and starts talking. Makes my chat super active. Huge fan of Zool.
Ditto. Like, yeah, every word, ditto.
Zool's a great guy. Everyone give a follow to Zool. He doesn't stream, but you should definitely give him a follow.
Go give him a follow.
So yeah, so we're gonna watch Toon Bellevue.
Yep.
I don't actually see him. Oh, I
don't
see
him.
Never mind. I got him.
Why am I blind?
Trust me when I say, with 100% certainty, if I can find them, they're there.
You've seen my selfies. You know I have to wear glasses to be able to read.
I'd also like to thank RicketySix for supporting my stream as well. So RicketySix and Zool, you guys are great people, and you're great additions to my stream and Black and Spoon.
Hey, right. Blick, you're okay, I guess. Thank you, RicketySix.
What can I say? I have some guys. They're very solitary to just me. And maybe 1-2-Q, because he's a handsome man.
I'm pretty sure like a good third of my followers only follow me in the off chance that Spoon is not streaming, just the way they can hear Spoon's voice as a proxy in my stream.
Oh, that's incredible.
Chaotic, that 1,500 big ones is our prize goal for next week's Bleck and Spoon.
So, we'd just like to point out that 1,500 isn't like the necessary amount that we need to have a prize pool. We just want to try and get everyone's expectations and goals. We want to try and make it a big, big tournament for Thanksgiving to thank the community and thank everyone for participating. We want to give back to the viewers who want to watch the stream. We want to give back to the players who are playing in the tournament. So anyone who just loves watching Splatoon, we're going to make it a big event for you guys on Black Friday.
Yeah. Our goal is to make as many people walk out of that tournament with something in their hands and something to show for it.
Yeah, whether you're a viewer or you're a player, we want to try and make you happy.
Yep, and we can only do that through support of our viewers, like you. And John Cena.
John Cena.
Charles Barkley, but that'll only happen when there's dunking.
Quick update on scores. Donkey Nuts takes it 3-2 on Kairos.
Wow, that's a surprise.
And Unknown takes it 3-2 on Leviathan.
They got distracted by the name.
That is a huge upset because Donkey Nuts, man. I mean,
Dem Donkey Nuts.
Just the name
alone. Dem Nuts, though.
Oh, Jesus. Nuts are running wild in this tournament.
By the way, we called it Splatsgiving Black Friday, but I mean, you could also call it Spoonsgiving because I'd be giving you all the spoons, baby.
That is the correct name.
Yeah. Once you dubbed it at the same time I thought of it, I was just like, okay, it's Q's name. Spoonsgiving Black Friday.
And Alex donating a $10. This one is dedicated to Black. You're always my favorite member of Cute. Spoon, you're okay, I guess.
That's not fair.
This is the best part about the fans of BNS. They're all trolls. I love them all.
Thank you, Alex.
If no, and nobody doesn't know, Alex is one of our cheerleaders. She's been one of the first people to support BNS. Also, she is a huge fan of Cute, has been with us since the beginning of our formation of our team. Because she was super attracted by the idea of four guys telling each other to suck a lot of dick.
Who's not?
I mean, none of our followers.
Alex is arguably a perfect human being.
Arguably?
There is no contest, in my opinion.
Definitively.
I say arguably because perfection is something that may or may not actually be obtainable, but if anybody can obtain it,
but
it's
if it
Alex.
Is possible, it's Alex.
It's Alex.
Also, Shadow, don't worry. One day, we will make the pickup team 1-2 Cute, and you will see my point sensor game on the stream.
Oh, 100%. It's not a question of if it will happen. It's a question of when it will happen, is really what we're waiting on right now.
I would just have to lose fast so I can come back here and cast, because this is fun.
Yeah, man. It's a great time. So, by the way, let's try and get this over 100 viewers. We only need 8 more viewers, guys, to get that 100. Remember, whoever's in the stream can win a chance to get Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Two more viewers.
2 more viewers.
Oh, really? Oh,
yep.
Let's get 2 more.
And if you want to help with that, go to Twitter, man. Just retweet. I know me, Blake, I'm sure everyone here has made a tweet about it.
Or make your own. We don't care. Twitch.tv/BlackSwordD2. Tweet it out. Get those free points. Or you can be like Rickety Sticks and discourage anyone from joining so that way you have a higher chance of winning Sun or Moon. Another valid strategy. Not encouraged,
trying to very like aggressively chase everyone out of the stream. He just have all of the points for himself.
Hold on, guys. I'll post the link in Twitch for you guys, so all you guys can retweet.
Why twice?
To make sure people know.
They...
Everyone leave. I love you.
Looks like we're about ready to get into it.
Alright.
Yep. Definitely going to start up really soon. So, by the way, for everyone in chat, speaking of Sun and Moon, what copy is everyone getting to anyone who is actually getting the game beforehand? I know personally myself, I'm picking up Moon because if you like Sun, come on, the bat's way better, guys, let's face it.
True facts.
I only speak the truth. I'm going to be very disappointed in anyone who picks Sun as the copy that they get, but I won't judge you.
God, it terrifies me every time. Hatchusville, thanks for the donation. $4.44. Rest in peace, Komodo, and I'm not playing because I need respawn. Scrunchy face.
We definitely feel the love. We definitely loved Komodo. They were huge supporters of BNS. So it's very, very sad to see one of our regulars go. We support all teams that play in our tournament. We love everyone who plays with us. We know everyone pretty much personally who plays in these tournaments, and we feel the love, and I'm sure that they feel the same that we give them.
Thank you, Hachi. To answer your question, though, I'm getting both copies of the game, but I'll be playing through Moon first.
That's the nice thing about having a significant other. You get one of each, and then you have all the exclusive Pokemon from each game, and all you gotta do is trade.
Punch me right in the feels, man.
Kicking him while he's down.
Don't be Q. Get an SO.
Exactly.
So
she does not have a 3DS.
Oh. Well,
I'm an old school Pokemon fan, but I tapered off after the Gold and Silver era. Because shit got too weird for me, and buying all those handholds got expensive. And this is actually, just from keeping an ear to the hype that has been Pokemon Sun and Moon, the first Pokemon game that I've actually strongly considered going out, buying the console, and buying the game only for this game. That is either a testament to their marketing, or just how great this game actually is. To pull me out of the recesses just for this.
I have to hope it's both.
I have a similar story, except with X and Y, said significant other forced me to get a 3DS and X and Y with him just so we get to play Pokemon together. So this is just a continuation of our tradition.
So I'd just like to say that in this, Leviathan and Unknown finished 3-2. That's an incredibly close game considering that Unknown is our number one seed.
Yeah.
Leviathan, who are these guys? Well, we get to find out right now. And we might be able to even show another amazing team on Bleck and Spoon. I just want to call it out. But we showed you Taylor. We showed you Deep Blues. Now look where they're at. Winning the Splatoon Showdown series. That's what's up.
For those of you Taylor who are familiar with Leagues Under the Ink, Leviathan has actually, I believe they started for the first time in Season 2, and they've made a return in Season 3 as well. And I fairly recall that they've done quite well in both seasons.
C Division survivors?
I believe they were Z Division survivors.
So, just the gaming, how the giveaway works is you just have to stay in stream and keep watching. Once we get out of the bracket stage of this tournament, we're going to have a chance for you to enter in the raffle. You have 100 points per ticket. You can use up to 5 tickets. You gain 10 points per 5 minutes. So, the longer you watch the stream, the more chances you have to enter into the raffle. So, just be sure to keep watching, and you can enter in to win a copy of Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Toon got exploded immediately.
Oh yeah, man, that was an amazing snipe.
What's everybody's counters at?
41.
39. Oh. 38. 37.
Oh, yeah, so we're all pretty close. But Toon getting a nice pop on that wall. Oh, Toon not winning a trade. Shrimp getting a nice kill, holding off that area. Man, Leviathan really holding this entire zone, like, really well. They have that full map control. Oh, and Toon gets
again.
Shrimp just going in on Toon, man.
Yeah, I just don't know if Tomo knows what to do at this point. Like, Leviathan has full map coverage at the moment. They have a Kraken in mid.
Yeah, it's starting to get dangerously close to the steam roll, which can happen on this map.
Yeah, usually when you reach that 30 point, it's very rare a team doesn't knock out because it's so easy to control that left side area. as you can see, heading down to 2019. It's just, it's a locomotive and it's not stopping.
Red Ferrate donating 1442. Hyped. Thanks for all that you do. Thanks, Red Ferrate.
Thank you.
I appreciate the oddly specific donation too.
I love all the oddly specific donations.
I feel like what a lot of people do is they just look at their last thing that they ordered and they're like, yeah, 1442. I ordered a sub. And that's definitely the amount I should give to Black and Spoon.
Well, sub makes sense, like 444777. These I get.
1442 is just oddly specific.
That one's out there, because I like it.
You know what, I'm going to look up what happened in the year 1442, just to give everybody a nice fun factor.
Columbus sailed the ocean blue?
Exactly, that's all.
Exactly.
That happened the whole year.
Didn't want to point that one out, though, because that's a gross fact.
I'd just like to say that Tome was actually getting a good amount of map control back. They're finally riding that tower. That whole map is yellow now. This could actually go back in favor of them as long as they can make sure they can control that sniper. Butter Dance on the tower. If he can just take out that sniper, I feel like they might have a really strong push. And no, looks like they could not. That tower got taken down by that killer whale. Nice stop so far by Leviathan.
Also, Bio, you're a bio major, so don't come in here correcting people on history. Come on, man.
Alex, thank you for the donation of 420 with the message of...
Yay!
Wait, what does the donation say? Not blaze it?
Nope, come not blaze on, it.
No,
just
no. It's perfect.
Oh.
Honestly, this is why I love Alex. I've been kind of waiting for that perfect opportunity to donate 420, just that I was waiting for my moment, but Alex totally beat me to it.
To be honest, if we're gonna talk about it, she was probably referencing the GIF of the lizard, where it's like, you know, laughing. I don't know.
Possibly.
Yo, if someone does 69-69, you're a legend.
Somebody does boob.
Boob is pretty good too.
Take the top donator spot away from the Jordan, who is currently holding a $20 donation.
Yeah, see, like, there is a first place right now in viewers and a first place in the tournament. And it looks like Jordan is definitely holding that lead. And Alex said I was right, so I guess I'm very accurate. Thank
Good
you,
job.
Alex.
Oh, well done.
So Tomo's still doing pretty good with some pressure. They're definitely holding it up, but there's one member down, four still up for Leviathan.
Yeah,
this is still Leviathan's. Yeah, this is definitely Leviathan's game to win. Oh, gets a nice kill on the tower. But Leviathan's still holding up, starting to get that ink pressure back. I don't think there's any way right now that Tomo can come back.
Oh, that bomb.
So I'd just like to say, I think we've reached a personal viewer record of 112 viewers. For all those who just tuned in, this is Bleck and Spoon. This is a weekly tournament that we run where we highlight teams who have never either played in tournaments before or teams that usually don't get recognition, or we also show teams that are really, really good. We show the entire gambit. We have specific rules for our tournament. We offer only one Kraken, one bubble, and no quick respawn. These are the rules for every single tournament. We love watching new players. In particular, we're starting to try and give back to the community because Splatsgiving is coming next Friday. So we're going to start off by giving away a Pokemon Sun and Moon copy because I know everyone's super excited about that. We're going to give away a raffle pretty shortly. We're also holding a donation drive because we want to make next week's Bleck and Spoon the biggest we've ever had, giving away prizes to viewers and giving away prizes to the people who play in our tournament, making everything special for everyone.
Rainbows, it's for just tournaments for next week's.
Yeah, so our goal...
Tournaments, prizes.
Yeah, for prizes. So right now, we are currently sitting at $351.83. Every cent of that will go into building up a prize pool. And what we want to do is make it as big and as great as we can do. And we want to make it so that way everyone next weekend walks out with something when it's all said and done. And the only way that we can really manage to do that is through your help. So we have the lofty goal of $1,500, and that is completely arbitrarily plucked out of the air. And we are happy
with... geez, that sounds like a nice number. Let's reach that goal.
Right, like that seems like something that's... We could make that. But it's also just enough out there that we could not make it. And that's what makes a good goal. so that is what we're aiming for. And what we can do for prizes for next week completely depend on how donations work out for the next week.
Like I like to say before, the things that we do have guaranteed for sure for viewers and for a tournament. I'll start with the viewers. Viewers will definitely be able to enter in raffles to get their customized Inkling drawings from Cammy, one of the artists of Splatoon, the Uberu herself. We also, four players, are offering first, second, and third place prizes from Cammy, Uberu, and the very own Inky Heart. On top of it all, we've already funded enough to definitely offer first place prizes of Splatoon pillows of the color of your choice and one to give away for the viewers. Future prizes are still to be determined. Stay tuned. We're trying to think of really exciting things to give to every single player.
Like I saw an Inkling towel where you could be a squid.
That was a towel. I thought it was a poncho.
Right? It's a towel that you put over your head, and you become an Inkling. And or a squid, I'm sorry.
I'd also like to announce, sorry, I forgot to mention this, but our very own regular team that has shown up every single week to BNS Stratosphere, we're going to be giving away one of their t-shirts live on stream as a viewer giveaway. We're also going to stream Stratosphere, hopefully, at the same time. So in this game, I'd just like to point out, I love Rainmaker Flounder. I think this is one of the strongest sniper maps, if you can get on the offensive. It looks like Leviathan has started off being the more aggressive team, keeping that aggression up on the roof. One thing I will say is, someone's running Bomb Sniffer.
Toon running Bomb Sniffer, it's great.
I have never seen a Bomb Sniffer in so long, but you see those skulls, and it's super evident.
Really want to make sure that he's run here too, right? Like, because you're going up so many walls.
Yeah, it definitely makes sense, especially if you're the one carrying Rainmaker a lot. Let you scope out to see what's around that corner before going up.
So one thing I like to say is, Tomo looks like they're having a really hard time trying to push up offensively in both of these games. You've seen them in the Piranha Pit game, not being able to really push out of their base until a little bit later into the game. And same thing here. It seems like Tumble has a really slow start and starts picking it up near the end. But for a team like Leviathan, it seems like they know how to hold once they get that initial push. Oh, but Tumble looks like they might get this lead. Oh, Toon getting a nice kill from behind. Oh, that Bomb Sniffer! Oh! Could we argue that Bond Sniffer saved him?
We could.
I mean, it wouldn't be a very strong argument, but you could make it.
Bond Sniffer to meta, guys.
I'm so sad Toon didn't get that kill on the Rainmaker.
Yeah, so it's really interesting. This game is super close right now. Tomo has the full advantage, but they just can't seem to push it through to get that lead.
But they do have control of top mid now, which is easily going to make or break this match, whoever has control of top.
Yeah, Butter the roof up there is with his super sniper. Important. Butter Dan being on top is probably one of the most important parts. If you can keep that sniper safe on that top platform, you can control the entire outcome of this game.
Mm-hmm. Because I have a trend of forgetting betting, here in the second round, go head and do exclamation point bet, followed by the 0 for Tomo, or 1 for Leviathan, and bet as many points as you see fit.
So Leviathan's still doing a really good job of holding. I mean, Tomo definitely still has control of this rooftop area, but Leviathan making sure that they are just stopping that Rainmaker push at every single point. Nice trade by Yalib.
Yalib.
Yalib. Billy.
It could be like that Alanis Morissette song, you know? Yalib, you learn.
Oh my god. Just with you.
Leviathan with the 2-0, man. This upset, guys. I can't believe what's happening right now. This team coming out of nowhere showing that they're not a team to be messed with.
People very quickly splatting in those Leviathan bets. We are going to cut off betting right there.
All right. Kairos has taken their set 3-0 on Rip the Dream.
Rip RTD. So Tomo is subbing out here. I wonder who they're going to bring in.
Let's take a moment just to acknowledge that that's the Butter Dan, arguably one of the most attractive Splatoon players in this community, right up there with 1-2-Q and Walkman 04.
Yeah, I'm like, if you want to argue about it, I'll argue with you about it.
This is why I'm not assigning rank, just putting them all up on a pedestal. I mean, you can determine where those pedestals lie by your own judgment.
We all know that Walkie's pedestal is the highest, though.
I don't disagree, for the record. But Butter does wear tank tops, so I mean, I gotta give him some props.
Absolutely. I'm a big fan of tank tops myself, so you and Butter are good in my book.
It's all about the tanks, man.
It's all about them tanks.
Hey, bro, nice tank. I know all your emotes. I can be a living 1-2-Q stream.
Because it's not, hey, bro, nice tank.
What is it?
Just, hey, nice tank.
Yeah, I know. There's also, hold on, if I were to follow you, it would be, hey, Cryptic Spoon, thanks for the follow. I love your face. Or something like that.
Good.
Hold on. I got this. Hey, it's Cryptic Spoon. Thanks for the follow, man. You are the sexiest person in the world, and I love your face. It's like 10
called
on 10.
Called out. So I just want to say, Kelp Dome Splat Zones is one of my favorite map modes in the game.
Right. We are now joined here by the Lucas.
Yeah, what's good?
Welcome,
guys, everyone,
Lucas.
Give a shout out to Lucas. Lucas is the Under the Scope, one of the founders of Under the Scope, it's bi-weekly podcast covering all Splatoon tournaments and meta info and community discussions. Yeah. I join him every second week with him, and we talk about games. It's a really interesting podcast. You guys should go give a follow to him.
And joining us with Lucas is also Aditya.
Hi!
Yo.
Welcome!
And guess what stream? Guess what today is?
Today is
Aditya's birthday.
Oh gosh! Oh gosh!
We'll sing out happy
birthday
right after
this. Let's get some
quads
for Aditya's birthday.
Yeah, word.
You guys are so nice. I'm gonna cry.
So, as we watch this game, back to the game. It looks like Leviathan's having a dominating lead. Like, Tomo's not able to get in. They have every entrance covered. Leviathan really showing some strategic play. Like, I have no idea where this team is coming from, but I want to see more of them. Because this play is crazy for a team that we've basically never heard of. I mean, other than seeing some results. Like, they are really showing that they can stand up to an A division team.
Are they like a pickup or?
There's a few members, at least one, PNK Shrimp, Private Ink Investigators. I'm not sure if a full-time Leviathan member or just subbing in for today.
Oh, that's a nice double. Oh, Kenny, he got the triple. Dude.
Oh, he gets the triple. In to
save this
oh my
game.
God, are they gonna get the zone? Please.
Good ink strike to cover the zone while staying hidden from the sniper, too.
Toon Man.
And the sniper's down. The quad.
Just want to say, Toon Man. The- that was some great
stuff. Disruptor combo. The disruptor combo.
Oh, still
oh my
going.
God, oh, around the corner.
Chat, let's get some shoutouts for Bucket.
Oh my God.
It's going off.
Bucket's best class.
Toon Man, like, what is this? He just turned on beast mode. He's like, no, we're not losing this game right now. I'm going to single-handedly win the entire game.
Jesus Christ.
Oh.
It was all a ploy to take
and
us in for the reverse sweep.
What a string,
it's still
though,
rolling.
Dude.
Look, it's still counting down.
Oh my God, awesome.
This isn't done.
They're going
to get back in there. Oh, they're so
work
close.
Work in tune.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah.
Oh, get it. Get it. Oh,
objective.
They did it.
Yes, they did it. Come on.
Oh my God, 17-16.
And they did it.
Hey.
Oh, no. Oh,
my God, what a comeback.
It's
a
knockout.
That's the comeback. Oh my God.
Damn.
All right.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Goodness.
Tomo heard that Adidia was joining this room, and everyone started laughing. And Toon's like, you know what?
Not
I'm
on Adidia's birthday.
I'm on my shoulders and win it for.
The best way to sum up the win was Leviathan forgot to fear the bucket.
Yeah. To be honest, that was insane.
11-4, beautiful.
Wow! Just when I was about to we were talking about. Like, who is Leviathan? And I was going to be like, yeah, I just wanted to point out, Shrimp has been kind of outplaying Toon this entire set. And then before I could even say that, it just goes in.
I mean, Shrimp has been.
Destroys that destruction.
You know, yeah. We were talking earlier about, like, people on the Black and Smooth tournament that have the ability to play, like, a fuckload of weapons, and Toon is one of those people.
Yeah, I've seen him on a lot of weapons as well.
Now he's gonna play Sloshing Machine. Just wait for it.
Better.
Expect clips, chat.
I'm expecting H3 from Toon here.
Let's get some plays. Let's get some woomies. Let's get that all up in chat. Because that was madness.
Yes.
I would arguably have to say that is probably the most hype play we've watched in all of the BNS series. Just like one individual player destroying people. Oh
that,
my
that
god.
Over the wall bucket, like, slosh, and then comes up the wall and burst cancels into the other enemy in the street. That was in like 2 seconds. That was so quick. You just got the double.
That whole streak was just incredible.
So, just a quick update while we were hyping out, there are some math results. Unity takes it 3-1 over Chibi Squid Squad. Matching a Breakthrough takes it 3-1 over Deep Blues. And Unknown tops EDPP 3-1. Oh, and Notorious just takes it 3-2 over Phoenix.
What?
Wow.
Good shit, Keimer. Oh my God. Legend.
Notorious?
Legend.
Yeah. Notorious, yes.
I would also like to point out.
That's
Notorious,
Jesus.
For I believe the first time in BNS history, has a stream going today.
Oh my god! We'll have to watch them. We'll have to watch Notorious, man. One of our favorites. They have literally been in every single BNS that we have had. They are one of our personal favorites, and we'll do the honor of definitely streaming them today.
Our favorite cast from a POV we've never seen.
It's true.
I called H3, I was so close.
Shrimp just kinda running circles around the L3 there though. It's kind of the downfall of playing a slightly slower weapon.
Hmm. Oh, they have so much control.
Yeah, the entire map is purple.
A very common challenge on the tower by Zayn.
Inkzooka shattered that confidence in a heartbeat.
When does Inkzooka not destroy dreams?
Perfect. I feel like Inkzooka is like the dream crusher special. Like, you always think you're about to do well, and then Inkzooka just...
The sniper's these, crazy.
These mad, yeah,
mad fish is going in. Dude.
Going in deep.
Mad good.
Oh my god.
Here on Black is going to be specialized in terrible puns.
Man, sorry, no, I still can't get over that first game. Like, well, why is it so mean well, but game. Like, I was just on cooldown from like, I was on cooldown. Oh man, from how great that play was. Like, oh my god. Like, even if Tomo loses this set, like, that is like, play of fucking 9 BNSs. Like, Toon, you're a legend, man. Like, oh my god.
This L3 is really coming into play with Toon right now. All these quick close range weapons are just able to poke their heads and cause some havoc for him. He's gotta pop the Kraken out at a really inopportune time. Is he gonna get blocked out by the wall?
Yeah, he's not gonna get the kill.
Outplayed, outmaneuvered, but no. We'll take it. That's the we'll take it special.
Going for a swim.
So unintentional trade. Up with this incredibly strong push, Tummel having a really hard time to try and get anything going for them. That their plat is painted in purple. They're trying to get it back.
Green pressure was out on the right side too.
Yeah.
Both left and right just controlled by them. But three members down. This could start of a push for Tummel. I mean, Buttered Dan looks like he's having some struggling trying to get up that platform there. But.
I feel like you're seeing kind of a repeat of game one where you had Leviathan keeping the pressure really high once they pushed in pretty deep into Tomo's spawn area, and then Tomo having a really hard time getting a push to happen because once they get back into that neutral stance, they can't like end neutral without having like two members down.
Yeah.
Oh, that trade.
That's our point. Oh, he gets a nice trade. Is this be
I wouldn't say
comeback?
That was a good trade. He was holding a full crack, and the tower was sitting right there at the edge.
Yeah. Well, in terms of that, yes. But getting the trade on the plat is usually a good trade without the Kraken, just because you want to make sure that it's clear when you're trying to move up there. But the tower still got taken out, so it didn't really change much, anyways.
Now you can just see like the pressure's already starting to build up on the plat. You got people coming pretty much every entrance.
I mean, but this is when you know Tummo's defensive, is when Butter Dan's on the left side and not on the right side. If he's on that left side, it means that your whole team is defensive and that you can't push up. So that is just a tale of how this game is going in the last minute right now.
Not looking good for Tomo here.
Less tune, like in the last game. Stands up and says no. Not today.
Oh, he says not in my house.
CRB is just getting some directs that are CRB exclusive.
Pretty nice.
You know, you get those like CRB directs, you're like, wow, this really shouldn't have been.
I never feel more dirty than whenever I'm playing a CRB.
Oh my goodness. I played it for the first time in tournament last weekend in the tower control. I like washed my hands after it.
Exactly.
I cleaned my game my game pad. It was like it was. It felt so gross. I took a shower.
And some people made that again. Weapon.
How dare they?
And there we go. Leviathan takes it 3-1 in a very upsetting set, man. Leviathan, who is this team? I can't wait to see more of them. That was some incredibly strong play, especially for a team that is not in A division. Damn, guys. Where are they? We got to get them in more tournaments. Holy shit.